talking street grill.
Catch a game with friends, meet for lunch, cocktails after work, or a romantic dinner for two. Whatever your plan, plan to do it at Sylvan Street Grill in Peabody and Salisbury. See you at Sylvan Street.
Eat, drink, and chill at the Sylvan Street Grill.
Hi, this is Saka Sarkisian, owner of Sarkisian Sportswear, located on Route 1 South in Peabody. We are a sports team dealer and custom apparel distributor that can handle all of your team's or company's uniform and apparel needs. So stop by and visit us at 182 Newbury Street in Peabody to see our storefront. Visit with our friendly and helpful staff and let us help you get the right fit for your program. Also, you can visit our website, SarkisianSports.com, to view our monthly specials and learn more about us.
All right, we're back at the half. What'd you have, Nick? Can he use those so we can... Thanks, Coach. All right, Nick Cooker is going to come in here and give Coach Ingram a break here while we go over some stats and look at stuff, and then we'll bring Coach back, maybe give us some analysis of this thing. But what a weird game.
I know.
Revere starting off like they were just going to blow downfield.
It's true. I feel like that's a theme. Just strange games that Gloucester's played in this season. You don't know what the game's going to be like. Though they've been pretty consistent the last couple weeks. But, first 13 minutes of the game, one drive each, and now Gloucester's got three touchdowns.
So Nick Kukuru is with us now. He's the Gloucester Times Sports Editor. And what'd you say you had? How many? What was?
I had him at 58 yards.
Sullivan 10,
8 of 13.
8 of 13. I got 56. So 8 of 13 for 58. And the team total is 44, so they've lost 14 yards running. So that's not
couple
a good sign.
Fumbles, couple losses of yards. They got away. I thought Revere got away from what was working. They were, you know, doing a nice job
hitting
those
curl
flat combinations, and then they just kind of stopped doing it. And they didn't need to after that first drive. They were only down 6-0, but now the floodgates have opened, and Revere's, you know, they're going to have to open it up a bit.
Well, I got Sanfilippo 14 carries for 155 yards.
Yeah, I got him 158, so
we'll go 158 then. Okay.
I'm a little more generous, I guess.
No, I can't see. I don't know. Half the time, I don't know who's carrying the ball.
Yeah, but if you get 10 people, 10 people would have different yardages. You know, we're all in 5 yards, you're good.
Now, earlier today, Gloucester Soccer won, I believe, 2-0. Who'd they
play? Lynn English. That was a big win for the boys. You know, they have to sneak out a few wins over the NEC Large, and it was a very evenly played game, I thought. And Gloucester, Thiago da Silva just buried two chances, and that was the difference. Bevan Worrell made a few huge saves and goal in the second half, so that was a huge win for them. They're back to 500 at 4-4-1, so they needed that. You can't get swept by the NEC Large if you're an NEC small team. So that was an enormous win.
Now I understand too that Coach Lauren Riley. What's Coach's married name? Lauren Riley.
Oh, I didn't even know she was married.
Coach Riley?
If she's married, it's Gove.
Gove. Coach Gove. That's right. I should know that. I know the Gove. Anyway, Coach Gove, the field hockey coach, who is due any minute now with her second child, lost a tough one. Danvers pulled out a 1-0 win in field hockey, knocking Gloucester out of the...
I mean, tough for her. She's about to, you know, give birth, and she has her two most nerve-wracking games of the season back-to-back. Danvers knocked them off for the first time, their first loss, and then a 1-1 tie with Marblehead, which was an outstanding game on Tuesday night, just the two titans of the conference.
And Gloucester has given up
two goals all season. Yeah, they. I did the math. They started off the season with a 300.